Hi everyone, Christina here. Welcome to another live here at my YouTube channel. My name's Christina Werner. If you're new, welcome, welcome. Today I'm going to be using some new products that just hit my craft room. I'm gonna kind of do a mix of different brands. Should be really fun, so I hope you'll stay tuned. And hello to everyone over in the chat. So glad to be back. I missed last week. I was out of town. I was in Disneyland. I was having fun with my friend Jen. We were trying to hit all the new rides. We hadn't been back to Disneyland, let's see, in 5 years. We used to go every single year, and then it got derailed. We went to Disney World 1 year, and then pandemic, and then and I've been to Disney World in the middle of that, but it's been a while since we went back to Disneyland. Disneyland is my first Disney amusement park love. It's so nostalgic. I love it. So it was fun to go back and see all the brand new rides, and we went on Mickey's Runaway Railway. That's like a tongue twister. I've been on it in Disney World. This is the version in Disneyland, which is it's essentially the same ride, but the like entrance and the queue to get in is different. So that was really fun. We went on all the Star Wars rides. It was great. So hello everyone in the chat. So glad to have you here. Let's switch over to the overhead. Hi, I'm in the corner. So these are the products that have hit my craft room recently. I've got three brand new things from Concord and Ninth. There's this stencil pack, and it'll do kind of a three-dimensional greeting. I thought it just looked really, really cool. So we're gonna try that out. They had a similar type of stencil set in their, it was exclusive to their holiday class this year. And I was a teacher and I got to work with it, and I just loved the stencil so much. So I'm driving with this. This looks great. And then this is the die set that coordinates with it. So you can cut out the outer area of the big hugs and add a secondary greeting. So I'm planning to add a secondary greeting on mine as well. And this is the stamp set that kind of goes inside the little banner. This is the stamp set that goes with it. Super, super cute. And then I thought, you know what, I'm gonna put this big greeting on this card. What can I put around it? And I think you could really just leave it plain. But I thought, you know what, I have this new 3D embossing folder. I fell into the trap. I became Spellbinder's kit subscription person. I subscribe. So this is, oh, isn't that just gorgeous? I thought it was really pretty, and the greeting will cover most of the center area that's open, but I thought that was just super pretty and kind of simple, and the big hugs could go on top. I haven't decided what color of cardstock to use for the card yet. I figured I'd go ahead and get my greeting figured out, and then I'd figure out the cardstock, but that is the plan for today. I'm gonna turn off this little thing in the corner so I can concentrate and I don't have to keep looking up, except to look at your lovely comments. Okay, so I'm gonna start with the stenciling. Don't need the die yet, but this stencil set, I think it has four stencils in it. Yeah, there's four. And they're really smart about it. They like, can you see that label up there at the top? It says layer one. So you know exactly how to put it all together. But I did kind of like think through this before I went live. So I've got a good idea of what I have to do here. So I've picked out some different colors of ink. I've got four colors of ink from Simus's stamp. I'm going to use the pink inks for the actual words. And then the shadow, you can see right here, there's a shadow, and I thought I would do that in gray. So I'm gonna start with, well, I'm gonna start by taping my paper down. On the stencil, it has little registration marks so you can match it up to your A2 card, so it's in the center. I'm planning to put this, like, die cut it anyway, so it doesn't really matter. But it does help when it comes to aligning your stencils. So I'm just going to tape my cardstock. This is just some Nina Classic Crest cardstock. And I'm going to line up those corners. It'll just help me get a better idea of what I'm doing here. Well, it's really close to that edge over there, but I hope it won't matter when it comes to die cutting. Okay, so I've taped that in place, and I'm going to start with the lightest color of pink. I'm just gonna put my little paw here. You know what? I totally forgot to grab my brushes for all the stenciling, so let me grab those. Thankfully, I have them in this, you know, the little holder thing. So I just grab them all and bring them over. Hello, everyone in the chat. Let's see. Oh, Natalie has the stencils from the holiday one. Love how they layer. Oh, they're so cute. I love those. Vare Blue. No, this is not a new wedding ring. This is my, I said this in a video recently. This is my travel ring. I wear it more now than my actual ring because it's actually like a half size bigger than my regular ring. And it just slides on and off a whole lot easier. I don't know about you guys, if you wear rings, but I've noticed that my hands are at different rates of like swelling throughout the day. In the morning, this ring fits better, but in the afternoon, my hands are all, they're not as big, and so my other ring fits better. Anyway, this one fits more. So I've just been wearing it in videos. It's not new. I've had it for a long, long time, and I've been wearing this one for a while, but what's funny is it looks so much like my actual ring. It's crazy. All right, I'm just gonna come in here and start stenciling, bringing in this very light pink. I want like a really good color on here. You could go for like very flat color, or maybe you have a little more color at the bottom of the words. You can get really creative with these large greeting stencils. Okay. Got a pretty good coating of all that color. I just want to hit some of the other areas that look a little bit lighter. Oh, this one bent. Oh, no, it didn't. Actually, I think it did. I think it did bend. That's okay. I think the shadow will cover anything up. Okay. So that was the color Bubblegum. So now I'm going to go to Sweets and I'm going to swap out my stencil. Oh yeah, it totally did. That's hilarious. That's okay. The shadow will probably take care of some of that. So this is layer two, and this is where you add the shadow. So I'm going to try to line up the registration marks, but you can also just sort of see where it's supposed to line up over what's already been stenciled. So I will tape this down. In fact, you know what? I'm gonna switch to a little bit of a stronger tape because I noticed my stencil was sort of wiggling just a little bit. So we'll just tape those down. And I'm using the color Sweets. In fact, we could zoom in a little bit too. There we go. I'm gonna use the same blending brush since it's still pink. And, oh, no, this is the shadow. We are not pink. We are not pink. This is the shadow. Caught myself. I'm using flannel. And I'm using a... I don't have my gray brush, so I've been... Wait, that looks like that's pigment ink. That is totally pigment ink. We don't want that one. We want a gray brush. Well, I guess I'm using this little one. That's the one that I have handy. Okay. So I'm going to come in and add the shadow. I want to cover up that pink area that I accidentally stenciled over. I think it's going to be a pretty minor mistake. It won't show much. Really, if you only wanted to do that first stencil for the words and then the second stencil for the shadow, you definitely could. Few people in the comments are asking about my craft room cleanup. I'm hoping to have a video update for you on Monday. I've done a few things to kind of get things back in shape so I can continue on with the organizing and purging and whatnot. And I also have a friend that's coming over and she's helping me. She loves organizing. She loves labeling things and just, you know, she's all excited about it. So she's going to be coming over this weekend to help a little bit as well. And I don't know about you, but if it's something that like, it seems to always be the last thing on your to-do list, so it never gets done. That for me is cleaning and organizing and purging. So having like a buddy that's going to come and like do it with you, I think is always so great because it's going to force you to do it. It's the same reason why, you know, people get personal trainers, I think, or one of the reasons why, because it's going to force you to work out. It's going to force you to, you know, focus on that one thing for a period of time. Someone in the comments like, you're so brave to show your messy craft room. I don't know that it's brave. I think it's that I knew that if I didn't make it a priority, if I didn't make it like, this is what I have to do to move forward. If I didn't do that, I wasn't going to do it, you know? And I knew that if I committed to showing it in a video or something like that, that I would do it. So this is where we're at. Okay. There's the gray shadow. Oh yeah, that cleaned up that area really well. Okay. So now I'm going to go on to the next stencil, layer 3, which adds like a little bit of a darker center area on the words. So I'm just getting this kind of lined up. I'm trying to look through my stencil, make sure everything looks good. I'm using the registration marks in the corners as well as sort of, you know, a clue for where to go. So now I can go to that sweets color. And I'm going to continue stenciling. And this is going to add like a really nice, intense kind of magenta. It's a really pretty color. I'm just adding ink on here, trying to get it as solid as possible. I don't know if I'll have time to do an envelope today for this card. If I do, make sure you put your address, submit your address in, because I'll pick someone from the comments here, or who's in the chat, I mean. Okay. Lift that up. Oh, I love it. It's already looking so good. Okay, and then this last layer adds like a little shadow so that it looks like, looks even more three-dimensional. Okay. Just getting everything lined up here. So I'm going to use my darkest shade of pink, which is Taffy. All right. And you know what? I'm going to switch to a smaller brush. I'm just going to go to this red because I just want to make sure I have enough, you know, bristles going all the way in to get all of the really, really teeny tiny areas. But I also don't want to have so much ink that it's going to start pooling under the stencil. You know what I'm saying? I've had that happen where I'm like, oh, I want more color. I want it more intense. And then I just keep adding more and more. And then I pull the stencil away and it's like bled. So this is the color Taffy. It's actually one of my favorite colors. It's kind of this like red violet. It's just a really good color. Okay. And for the big reveal, I'm gonna get these brushes off my work surface so I don't accidentally color something I don't mean to. Okay. Lift this up. Ooh, that looks really cool. All right, I'm gonna go, I know these red inks will stain stencils. They've probably already stained the stencil, but I'm gonna go ahead and come clean off the stencils in my sink just to be sure. Run some water over them. Thankfully, these inks clean off stencils really easy. But as suspected, it did stain them just a little bit. So I'll just run these under some water. And a little tip for you when it comes to stenciling. If you don't have a sink or like a water source or something in your crafting area, wherever you're working, you can have like a, get like a large bowl or something, fill it with water and just have it off to the side. And as soon as you're done with your stenciling, whether it's paste or inks, anything like that, you can just throw your stencil in the bucket of water or in the container of water and then you're all good. Okay, I've got this weird spot right here that is like not taking ink. I don't know what is happening right there. It's like this weird bit of cardstock. I'm like, what is going on? I have no idea. I'm gonna have to ignore it. All right, I love how three-dimensional that looks. I almost wanna take the stencil that did the center one and like stamp like a really tiny itty bitty dot. Wouldn't that be cool? Or I guess I could add that with markers. Let's do that. Because I'm thinking about it. I've got these markers right here. I'm just trying to figure out which color is going to go best. I'm guessing this one. All right, if I did that and I just add a little tiny dots. Okay, they're not going to be uniform. And I think I don't want them quite that dark. Let's try a different color. I've got like a lighter pink that over the top of that one probably would work. I don't know. Let's just do a little dot in a little area. Oh, it almost gets lost. You can hardly see it. I mostly just want like a texture. Yeah, I like that. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. And it might even dry back even more. Yeah, as it dries, it's almost like going away. It's hilarious. But I'm gonna go ahead and add all these dots in anyway. Not in any particular pattern or anything. I just kind of random. I just want, you know what, it's really fading back. It's showing more on camera than it is in real life, which is hilarious. I think what I'm trying to recreate with these dots is on like very retro printing, like from the 50s and 60s, you'd have that dot pattern or almost like comic book. You know? And I think that's what I'm thinking it needs. Just a few more little dots to add on this uppercase B. The fact that they're really fading back into the pink color, I'm not worried about being precise or anything with the dots. Okay, yeah. Where I added them at first, it's really fading back. Looks really fun though. Okay, let's die cut this and move on. Okay. What is up with my remote? It does not want to work today. Okay, so here's the die set, the Big Hugs stencil set, and then this is Sending Hugs Dies. Come out, dies. There they are. Okay, so we need the outer. We need the outer one, and I'll just go ahead and arrange this on my magnetic mat in my Empress Mini. Oh, it is like the exact width of like an A2 card. Well, I'm planning to put this on a 5x7 anyway, so I guess that's good, right? I kind of like that it's a bigger greeting. Or if you like skewed it, you could have it go off the edges of your card. I think that'd be really cool. All right, that's pretty centered. Run this through my die cutting machine. All right. Oh, and it just barely didn't get that edge because it was hanging off the edge. That's okay. I can do get that with scissors. Just clean up that little edge. That's nothing to do with the die itself. I think the die is fine. It's just it was hanging off this edge. Okay. I don't know how. Oh, it was like this. Perfect. Okay. Okay, so let's worry about, not worry, but do the texture to go behind my greeting here. I thought this embossing folder would be so pretty. Ooh, like a light gray cardstock would be really pretty. All right, so you can, we'll just open this up and we'll picture this like it'd be right over the top. Wouldn't that be fun? I love that. Okay, like a light gray, maybe like fog from Simon's stamp, or really light pale pink like cashmere from W+9. Let me go grab a couple of cardstock options. And we'll figure out exactly what to do. Okay, cashmere is looking a little bit too orangey. I'm not sure what color this is. I think it's, I have no idea. It's about the same as C9 ballet slipper. Okay, so ballet slipper, I need to find, Simon's Stamp Fog. I organized my cardstock this week, so that's really great. All right. All right, so we've got, like, this is Fog from Simon's Stamp. And then this is Ballet Slipper. Let me grab a sheet of it. This is Ballet Slipper from Concord and Ninth. That's almost too much. I do like the gray. A light pale lavender would be really pretty too. And before I knew exactly what colors I was using, I did cut out a sheet of sea glass from Concord and Ninth. I love that. That's so retro. I like that. Black would be really pretty too. Someone just mentioned that in the comments. I'm liking either black or sea glass. Or a dark gray would be really pretty too. What am I feeling today? Let's, you know what? we can do, we'll do both. We'll do black and dark gray. We'll do all three. Why not? Let me grab the black and a dark gray. All right. There's some black. And let's see. I know I have a dark gray somewhere. Mushroom from Concrete and Ninth is a little bit of a really warm gray, so I don't want to do that one. Let's see here. Graphite from Spellbinders. There we go. That's a good option. Okay. I'm just collecting all the different cardstock colors, so any one of those. Ooh, the black is really striking. But the gray would show texture. Okay. I'm eliminating the sea glass. I'm going to cut down these two to 5x7. So I could either have it go portrait, or it could go, you know, it kind of fits better portrait. So we'll do portrait. It doesn't matter. It's going to go through this the same direction anyway. All right. So before I put this through my die cutting machine, I'm going to just spritz it really lightly with a little bit of water on both sides of the cardstock. And that's going to help it get a really good impression as I put it through my die cutting machine. So put that in, and then like that, and I'm going to run it through my Anna Griffin Empress. And if I remember correctly, for these Spellbinders embossing folders, I think it's just one plate. No, that's not going to be enough. I'm just trying to figure out the best sandwich. Okay, it's a, you just eliminate one of the clear cutting plates. So I ran it through just like this with just a clear cutting plate, metal shim, magnetic mat, and then the embossing folder. Oh, that's gorgeous. That is so pretty. And then we just have to let it dry a little bit. I'm going to go through and do it with the graphite cardstock now. All right. And I love their 3D embossing filters because they're oversized. They're like, you can do a full 5x7 and there's still room around it. It's amazing. Since we do have a really retro look with this greeting over here, I think you could do like a, what's the word? Like just a polka dot background would be really pretty too. All right. I'm gonna put this embossing folder away really quick. I like to keep them in their original packaging because it has the name of the one. This one's called Floral Archway. So I just like to keep it in their original packaging. Okay. So now we get to decide which is going to look best. Do we like it on the gray? So pretty. Or on the black? Oh, I don't know. I think it could go either way. I think both are really nice. I'm gonna put my plates away, turn off my die cutting machine. I'm not quite sold on either one yet. Black or gray? I'm thinking no matter which one I do, I might do just a little little spatter of silver metallic watercolor or ink over the top. I think I like this one more. And you know what's interesting? I spritzed this one with a little bit more water. Like this one was a light dusting of water, and this one I sprayed it a whole lot more. And more details are coming out. It might be because of the color of the cardstock. I'm not sure. But I just find that really fascinating. All right, this one is still really damp, so I've got to wait for it to dry or speed it up. I'll just use my heat tool. Add that. I'm going to go with the gray. Here. Now, adhering embossed panels to a card front can sometimes be challenging. You know, I didn't even consider just doing it over white. I could have just done it over white and kept it very light and bright. Oh crap, do I need to do the embossing folder in white now too? I really do like it, like over white. I like it over white. I think it's a little bit more subtle. Okay, we're doing white. We're narrowing it down, right? Okay, gotta take the embossing folder back out of the packaging. Sometimes when you're making color choices, you just have to try a few different ones because you don't know what you're gonna do. And I got it really wet this time, just like the gray, and we'll see how that goes. All right, back into the die cutting machine. Ooh, that is really pretty. That is really, really pretty. Okay. I don't think I could lose either way, but which I like that this one, because of the white outline on the words over the white background, the cut outline looks like it fades a little bit. All right, I'm gonna get my keyboard out and I'm gonna put a poll in the chat. I don't have my keyboard out usually. So I just have to go find, okay, hold on 1 minute. I normally don't have this all set up, so. Like I have to do it through YouTube. I can't do it through the app that I usually use. Oh, how do I get there? Hold on, I'm figuring out how I can add a poll. Mm. Oh my word, how do I even, oh, there we go. Found it, found where I have to go. Okay. Okay, where's the add a poll thing? Oh, I used to know where this was at. Hold on, I'm figuring it out, y'all. I can see your comments coming in. Start a poll. There we go. Okay. We're going with dark gray. Which color background? Dark gray or white? Okay. Pretty sure the poll should pop up for most of you. And I'll just keep watching the results to see. All right, so white or gray? You tell me. I'm keeping the card simple. I'm not gonna be doing anything else to it besides this, except I might add a little tiny thin frame border on it, but yeah, you tell me. I think it's pretty 50-50 right now. The white's at 56%. I mean, I could, someone saying highlight the flowers with ink or whatever. I could highlight things in a little bit of white pigment ink on the gray, or I could even bring in like a pale pink for the flowers on this one over here. It'd be pretty too. Either way. Okay, I think the white is just barely winning out. Deb's asking, do you think cutting into the mat is sharper than the die against the top plate? No. I think you get a sharper cut going into the clear plate, but I cut into the magnetic mat all the time just to add convenience, and it does still work. Okay, white is a 55%. Well, I need to dry this one. I'm going to dry this, and when it's done drying, I'm just going to take whatever color is in the lead. Would have been ideal to let this air dry more because then it doesn't warp as much. As you can see, this is really kind of warped right now. The gray is warped too, but I can straighten that out a lot with when I adhere it. Okay, still not dry. It's holding on to a lot of moisture. That's feeling much more dry now. All right, let's just continue on with Like right now, white is just barely ahead of the gray. But just because I'm curious, let's try adding a little bit of inking on top of both and see what happens. Okay, so I'm gonna take this pink. I want it to be very, very faint, so I'm just gonna take what's left on the brush. I'm not even adding any. Oh yeah, that's pretty. Adding just this little tiny, a little bit of pale pink just on there, really pretty. I'm just using whatever ink is left on the brush, really. Could even, let's see, do I have any purple on this one? Not really. Do I have purple on this one? No, they're all dry. That's because I recently used the pink one. But adding just a little bit of that, I don't know if I like that. I think I would need to add green in for the leaves. All right, I'm gonna grab a really pale green. Do I want a bright green? Yeah, brighter green. Celery. And I'm gonna get a little bit of ink on there and then get most of it off. And then do I like that? I don't know if I like that. I don't know if I like this, y'all. I may have ruined my beautiful white background. I mean, just not for the look of this card. I mean, like, I think the big hugs is too bold for how like faint and dainty this is. You know what I'm saying? I think it, yeah, no. Maybe I just don't like this embossing folder with this grading. I think that's where I'm at. The embossing folder needs like a very ornate, more flourished greeting, or just something very, very simple. And this greeting is so stylized. It's very that retro. I think it's that's what I'm not liking, that the embossing folder is clashing with the style of the greeting. Okay. I'm thinking that I'm gonna have to grab a different embossing folder, or maybe even do like patterned paper. Patterned paper would be really fun. Okay, let's maybe just an ink blended background. What am I doing? Okay. I liked this retro feel. I really liked that. I'm going to find an embossing folder to work with it. Actually, do I want an embossing folder? No. I need something that's like a really bold background. Okay, hold on. And it's 5x7, so all of my 6x6 stencils will not work. I've got a bunch of big stencils I'm gonna choose from. Oh, something like this could be fun. Oh, okay. All right. Okay, I'm looking through some stencils.
I have some like big ones from Stencil Girl that work well with stuff like this. Okay, this one's very retro. Ooh, but I liked the first one most. Right? I think it just looks cool. Okay, trees, stars, hearts. Okay, we're going for the little bursty one because that, I think, is just gonna look the coolest. All right, do we like the really random burst or do we like, I think I like the one that's a little bit more uniform. And it could just go on like that. Yeah, I like that. Okay. Let's get this kind of centered a little bit, but more near the top. And then I'm going to tape it to the stencil from the back so that I can have it go off the edges. And then I'm going to go grab sea glass ink from Concrete and Ninth because like the same color on top of the ink would be great. Okay, and because I'm paranoid about going off this bottom edge, I'm actually going to take a little bit of Post-it tape and just protect that area. And that'll also help kind of stick it to the stencil. Okay. I've got my sea glass ink. I might have to pick a slightly darker ink as well. Hold on, I'm gonna grab, is it Peacock is the next one I want? Or Oceanside? Probably Oceanside. Yeah. I'll do Oceanside as well. And here we go. It's a very skinny little stencil. You know, I want to say Concord and Ninth might even have a stencil that's kind of like this burst pattern. If I have it, I wouldn't know where it's at. Okay, I'm just going all the way around. That embossing folder is so pretty. I really do want to do some sort of project with it. I just have to find the exact right greeting for it, you know? It's such a beautiful embossed pattern that you have to like find something that's gonna do it justice. Okay, so that was sea glass. I'm gonna take just, okay, cause like this, I'm gonna take a little bit of Oceanside and kind of come out from the center because I want just a little bit of a concentration of color, a little bit darker coming from that center. Okay. Let's take a little peek. Oh yeah, oh yeah, that's gonna be good. In fact, I think before I move on, I'm gonna grab Midnight, which is like just, you know, Peacock. Midnight would be too dark, I think. But Peacock is like just a little bit of a darker shade. And I think that's gonna be perfect. just like really emphasize that it's bursting from the center. I don't even know how much this color will show once the words are on top, but I'll know it's there. Okay. All right, now let's take all of this off. Oh yeah, love that. That was a good choice. Oh, that's so fun. I kind of wish it extended even further out, but I still like it. Yes, I think that was a good choice. In fact, I might cut my card down to be more square just so it fills the space a little bit more. And you know what else it needs? It needs some little dewdrop little thingies. Looking through all my sequins, trying to find them. I know I have some. I have some little itty bitty ones, but I want bigger ones than that. I know I have some. Oh, here we are. Ooh, and they're like iridescent. I love that. Bubbles. All right. Let's figure out the size of my card first. Sorry, I'm like moving things around in my craft room with my feet, my little footstool. Okay. So that's going to be adhered to card front. I'm not entirely sure where I'm going to cut it down yet. So I'm just going to adhere it as is. Make sure I've got plenty of adhesive. And then I can cut it down. Okay. Put some foam tape on the back of this because I can. Cut some other smaller little foam bits so I can go in these little areas. So there's just a little bit of support under them, you know? I totally forgot we have a secondary grading to stamp and die cut. We'll get there. Okay. In fact, you know what? Before I do that, I need to die cut this little banner because I need to figure out where it's going to go. Okay. And that means I need to stamp my greeting first as well. I'm going to try to grab my mini Misty. Is my mini Misty in here? Oh, I just got black ink all over. Not all over. Just a good portion of my fingertip. Oops. Okay. Mini Misty is MIA. So we will be stamping in the regular Misty, and I'll do it at the top corner because I don't have space on my work surface. All right, where'd that stamp set go? There it is. All right, I think I'm gonna have it say, love you lots, I guess. I think that could be really cute. In fact, I think I might stamp a couple of those little hearts too, and die cut them. So or just cut it. I don't know. All right, so love you lots. I need to have a little space to cut that out, so I'm gonna put it right there. And just to make it, let's see. If this is like this, secondary greeting, I think could probably be in Oceanside or Peacock and it would look really great. Or I could have it be in Taffy. I'm having second thoughts about the color of cardstock. I think I want it in, I want Peacock cardstock with white embossing. I think that's gonna make it really stand out. So, I'm grabbing some Peacock cardstock. I'm just gonna trim it down a little bit so it's easier to work with. Okay. There we are. Using my anti-static powder tool. And have my Versamark ink ready to go. Oh, I should have done my powder after I had the stamp there. Let's do a little more powder. Okay. Using Versamark ink. And then I'll use some white embossing powder. This is Alabaster embossing powder from British Monroe. I'll just heat this until it's melted. Heating up my heat for a little bit. Griffin Mini Empress. They always put these little tabs up here to show that that's the way that should be pointing up. I'm getting it centered. Run that through my die cutting machine. Okay, and now we have a little banner shape, which I believe, yes, it does have score marks on it, so you can make it into an actual banner. So cute. All right, so I'm gonna put it like, how did they have it on their example? Like that, okay. I'm like, how was Jen envisioning this when she was designing it? Because I have a suspicion that my friend Jen is the one that did this one. There's only a few designers at Concord and Ninth. I happen to know all of them, but I know Jen's style more than anyone's. Okay, so I'm gonna put this about right here. And then, let's see, I wanna get this folded a little better. Okay. I think I'm gonna just put a little bit of foam tape right underneath it. So I will cut my foam tape.
And I'll do just like that. Remove the backing, and then before I put it on, I'm gonna put just a little bit of glue under, or I should say, on the ends. And then let's see. Yeah, I'm getting that glue all smeared everywhere, but that's okay. Put it down just like that. Clean up the little glue. I love that. Okay. So now I'm going to just trim this down. It's not going to be square. I thought maybe it would be square, but I think it's going to be just a little bit taller. In fact, it's not so bad. I just hate this area at the bottom that, like, it just doesn't look quite right to me. So I am going to use a T-square ruler, and I'm going to cut this with a craft knife. And cut it about right there. And I'm going through like three layers of cardstock. So I'm just going to do really light cuts, not pressing too much until it's gone through everything. It's getting close. There we go. Okay. And then I'm going to take just a little bit off the top too. Maybe like this much. And once again, just very light cuts. Okay. Oh yes, I love that spacing so much more. You know, it looks like the cover of a book. It looks like the cover of a book to me. Love that. All right, we're right at an hour. I kind of do want to do a envelope for this, but I don't know if I'll have time to do the lettering on it. So maybe, I'll just do a little design on the envelope. Call it good. Amanda's asking if there's a reason why I didn't use my paper trimmer to cut it down. I chose not to, mostly because it was three layers of cardstock, and my paper trimmer could handle that. It would be okay. But I'm just like, I feel like I have a little more control over it with a craft knife and a ruler, especially when you're like figuring out where exactly you want to cut. I don't know. Either way, personal preference, I suppose. Okay, I'm just cleaning this up just a little bit, getting this stuff out of the way so I can think about an envelope. And I also need to get this little dude back on there. And that is not the right package for that. We'll just put it over there. Okay. If you have not put your address in for mail art during this live stream, go ahead and do it now. I think I'm just going to do a really simple, quick envelope. And while you're entering those addresses, I'm going to go put this stencil in the sink and run some water over it and possibly grab an envelope. Thinking a white envelope is probably going to work best on this one. In fact, I might use this stencil on the envelope, so I'm going to go ahead and dry it as well. I just have a towel over here. I'll just dry the stencil really quick.
white envelope. Okay, I have no idea where this envelope is from, but it's white. It's 5x7. I have no idea where it's from though. And this card should fit in it just fine. Just a little bit of room to spare. I'm not even gonna worry about putting in another piece of cardstock to make it fill the envelope because I think it'll be just fine. But I definitely know this is under 1 ounce, so I'm not gonna worry about it being too thick or too heavy. All right. Let's pick some postage. Y'all, I have so much postage I need to put into my postage stamp albums. I can't eat, yeah, there's so many. Okay, we're going retro and I'm not doing anything crazy that would make it non-machinable. So we could totally go all vintage and do different colors. Okay, I'm gonna have to back out here. And so we can look at all of the postage stamps. Okay, here we go. We need a pink, right? We need pink and we probably need a teal. Ooh, I have the perfect teal one in mind. Where is it? It's Mississippi. Ha ha, that's the one. Seriously, I mean, come on now. Okay, so we've got Mississippi, and then we need a pink. My pinks are back here. Oh, okay. All right now. Okay. I think that would go well. All right. Now, like, Well, we need something that's a larger quantity. I kind of got a flower theme going here. I must just be filling the flowers today. I keep trying to use flowers. Green, teal. I could also look through some of those stamps that I have not put into the album yet. You know what? Let's look through some forever stamps because I need to get, hold on, I'm gonna sneeze. Okay, I totally muted in time. I sneezed. Okay, let's get a forever stamp. My stamps are all the way across the room or on the other side of my desk, so I have to walk around. Okay. Okay. Any in here that would work well? Okay. Oh, this down here is the exact colors. That is hilarious. I want something that looks a little more retro, though, like... So let's just flip through and find something. Has to speak to me, right? Some little ice creams would be kind of fun. Elvis stamp would be kind of cool. Keep my finger on that page. Okay. Sesame Street, always fun. This kind of teal color, that might be the winner. And I really don't know how much of those colors I'm going to use on the envelope, so I'm going to keep it simple, right? All right, let's do this one. So it would be those three stamps. Actually, you know what? I'm not convinced on that one. I feel like it needs to be pink. I want a forever stamp that is mainly pink. This is why it takes me so long to do mail art, because I have to go through 5 million albums looking for looking for the right color of postage stamp. Okay. One of those could be cool. Oh, that might be the winner. Yeah, that's the winner. Okay. Keep this page open so I can put those stamps back. All right. Make sure the flap's on the right side. Now these two are the ones you would normally like lick and then stick to your envelope, but we're not doing that because these are super old stamps. I don't know where they came from. So I'm just gonna use a glue stick. You can also like use I've wet paper towels before and then, or a sponge and press the stamp into it. I remember back in the day, I'm not sure what it was for, but me and my siblings were putting a bunch of postage stamps on things. And we actually had like a little dish with a sponge in it that we used to put all the postage stamps on. That would have been like late 80s, early 90s. Okay. I'm trying to figure out what exactly I'm going to do on the envelope, because so much of the styling of the card is in the words, right? So, I mean, I guess I could try mimicking that style of writing. I don't know that I have the time or the energy for that, but that is an option. I'm thinking that's probably the better option. Okay, but I also have my little stencil. I could do a little burst or something. Nah, I think I don't want to. But I do want to do, I don't know. I think maybe I'll just keep it really simple. Okay, let's pick an address. People who have entered it since the beginning of my life here. Okay, let's find someone. Okay, I'm just going to scroll and then just wherever my cursor lands on. I'm going with Pamela in Saratoga Springs, New York. Pamela, I hope you're here. Write down the address, make sure I have it correct. As soon as I can find a pen. Okay. Oh, it's a pencil anyway, that's okay. Pamela Moniz, maybe? Okay, Pamela, make sure that is your address. That's a 6 on the NR. Oh, Billy, thank you so much. Okay, has Pamela piped in yet with the saying that is the correct address. All right, I'm gonna figure out what markers I'm going to use. Let's see. I think I will use some Karen markers. And I'm going to match the colors. Monied. Oh, that's a cool last name. I like that. Okay, I'm going to test out some different colors. I'm thinking that color might be a fairly good match. Or it can, because it's kind of like a purpley pink shade we've got going. That pink's a little too bright. Okay. So it's either that one or I'm gonna have to pick up some pastel colors. Okay. Oh, I don't think any of these are gonna work. I think that's the color because nothing else is going to work here. Okay. Or I could go not do pigment deco brush and go with regular Karen markers, which is an option. Let's look at those. All right. Here are the colors. I think like 358 is, actually 075 might be even better. Yeah, 358, which is right here. Oh my word, that's hilarious. Look at that. Are they the same color? This one's red lilac. Red lilac. That's hilarious. I didn't even mean to pick the exact same color, but that just goes to show that my color picker is consistent. Hannah says, you guys remember when the winner was in the chat and was able to correct her address? Yeah, that's why I ask. Because, you know, like, you never know. Okay. All right. Oh, sorry. Picked the wrong little thing on my screen. There we go. Okay. So Pamela Monique. Okay. I'm going to use a little bit of white cardstock. I'm just going to practice how I want to write her name. So this is the regular, like the original Brush Marker Pro. I'm just like deciding, like, is this what I want to do? I don't know. I know that's not her full name. Then there's this this other one that I have to shake. It's a pretty good color match. Okay, this one. It's a little bit of a softer brush. I could use both of these together, actually. That's not a bad idea. I'm gonna do that. Okay. I'm going to shake this one up a bit more. Yes, yeah, squeaky pen. Definitely a squeaky pen. Just shaking it up so I get a really good result.
Okay.
I'm gonna shake it up some more. Get up a little bit. Okay.
Trying to decide if I want to add a flourish here or not. I don't think I do.
Okay, and then
her last name is going to be right here.
It's getting a little dry, so I'm going to shake this up again. Okay. Okay.
I'm gonna fix this spot right here.
All right, and then I'm trying to decide if I'm gonna add in a little bit of this darker color. I think I do want to. I could put it in as a shadow even. Okay, let's test it over here on my practice one. If I was gonna add it in as a shadow, I don't like that as a shadow, but I could add it as a like a little accent. That could be kind of fun. Or I just leave it as is. I could go either way. Trying to decide exactly how what I want to do. Oh, what if I made it so it was like the bottom half has the darker color? That could be fun. Not those lines on it, obviously. I do want to add this color on here. I just don't know exactly where I want to do it. It doesn't have to completely mimic the card design, right? It can be whatever we want it to be. So I have a better idea. Hold on, let me find the right brush for this. This is a watercolor brush. Like, you can do watercolor with it. So, not that I want to make this harder on myself, but all right, I need just a little bit of water. Gotta go get some at my sink. Okay. This might not be the wisest decision, but we're gonna go with it, especially because this is not watercolor paper that we're dealing with. And I've never done this before. In fact, let's just test it over here. I've never like watercolored on top of the pigment deco brush. Okay, now I know it has to be a very small amount. In fact, I think I'll turn it like this. but like just give it a little bit of a shading at the bottom. I think it could look pretty cool. Just to give it just a little bit more dimension. Zoom in on this and just like spurting out a little bit so I can work here. So I'm adding a little bit of the color from the marker and then cleaning off my brush and coming back with just clean water just to fade it out just a little bit. I don't want to add a ton of water to this envelope because it's, you know, like I said before, it is not a watercolor paper that I'm dealing with. In fact, I'm not even sure where this envelope is from. Just shadow along the outer edge, and it was just a little bit easier to turn this upside down while I work on it. I liked having the other shade, but it was just almost a little too intense. So bringing it in using water just dilutes it down just a little bit. And I think makes it a little bit more easy to work with. Don't you worry, I'll be adding a shadow to this after I'm done. Okay, so it just looks a little bit, just a little bit of color variation. Okay, where'd that marker go? I need more. Oh, I just picked up the wrong one. We don't need that marker. We need this one. There we go. I like that it's adding a little bit of a texture. Like it's not as smooth. I think it looks kind of neat. Ooh, you know what I should do? I should add those little that little dot texture that I put on the card. Okay. I didn't add a ton to it. In fact, I probably could have picked a more contrasting color if I wanted it to be like a little bit more of a like super like noticeable shadow. But okay, I'm just cleaning up my palette here before I move on. Okay, so I'm gonna hit this with my heat tool just a little bit. I mean, there's not much water, it's drying pretty quickly, but I'm gonna just hit it with some heat just to make sure it's completely dry before I add on this shadow. What's interesting is the colors are drying almost the same. So it just makes me think that Karen markers, they have their color consistency down. Okay, I'm gonna grab, I think like a Copic N, probably N1 or N2 would probably be perfect. Actually, I'm thinking N2 or N3. We'll test both. But I find adding shadows with Copics to be the easiest. So, all right, here's N2. Oh, that's dark. Maybe N1 really was what I wanted. Oh yeah, N3 is way too dark. We want N1. Of course, my Copics are all the way across the room. That's just how it is. Okay, N1 it is. Linda's asking, is there a deadline date for the mail calls? Just try to get them in the month like you want it to be. Like if you're going for February, try to mail it, you know, a few days before the end of February, depending on how long it's going to take to get here. I usually will go check my mailbox the first week of the following month, so first week in March, and I'm trying really hard to get my mail call videos up within the first week. I wasn't able to this time because I was going out of town, but within the first week. So you definitely have until the end of the month. Okay. Oh yeah, N1 is where we're at. Okay. So I'm just gonna add a little bit of shadow. I'm not adding much Copic ink on this. Like I'm not adding a ton. So I'm not concerned about it bleeding through. It probably will a little bit onto the inside of the envelope. I'm not that concerned. Okay. And then we will do her address. And I'm gonna show you guys another little tip. Laser level. I used a laser tool on when was that? My video that was on Wednesday. But you can also just use a little laser level that you can move around yourself. And you just, you know, get it exactly where you want it. And then you can just use that for your line as you write your address. In fact, I'm gonna bring this down just a little. There we go. Yeah, right there.
All right, and I'll slide this up a little. Okay. All right. And then I'm just going to do my return address on the back. Looks like I got a little tiny dot of pink right there. Not a big deal though. All right. So I'll put my name right here. And then I can put my address right below. Slide that laser down so I can get the next area. And this is just my UPS mailbox. It's not my home address or anything. And I tend to change exactly how I write either mailbox or just number or whatever to try to make it center. So that's what's happening there. It'll all get to the same place if it has to be returned. Okay, and then as far as protecting the envelope from moisture, I'm gonna have to do a little bit of microglaze. The laser level, I would say, using it like this, it was a little bit more challenging in comparison to that laser tool from We Are Memory Keepers that I used in my video on Wednesday. So I would say if you're gonna use a laser level like that, you might want to like use a grid mat and tape your project down and then use your level and make sure the level goes from side to side right across the grid lines, if that makes sense. Actually, you know what? I will do the microglaze here in a minute. I want to add something else onto this because it doesn't look finished to me. I think I'm just going to add some little hearts around it or something with this marker. I think that could, oh, even better. Well, maybe. Oh, I have a good idea. We're gonna do this. Okay. Grabbing the N1, because we're going for the retro look, right? Let's see, do I wanna do this? I do. Do I? I do. You know how I said it reminded me of the dot pattern, like with old comics? I was making this a little bit more uniform, but I'm just gonna make it really random now. In fact, you know what? Yeah, I am. Every once in a while, I'm gonna have a little heart. because why not?
Okay. And I'm not planning to put the dots completely covering the envelope. I'm going to have them kind of fade out. Yeah, I like that. Turn a couple of the dots into little hearts. Okay, I like that. Just a little something. Okay, we've been going for almost 2 hours. Here we are. Here is the card and envelope for today. I'm going to do a quick little spiel for those watching the edited replay, and then I'll come back and just ask a couple of questions. I saw a few fly by that I wasn't able to catch. So I'm going to say the eye, oh, the shadow of the eye over her name. Yeah. There we go. Okay, yeah. So here we go. Let me do a little spiel for those doing the edited, watching the edited replay. Okay, so here is the card and envelope for today. Hope you guys enjoyed. I really loved this stencil set, so retro looking, and I kind of love this envelope that came out at the end here as well. So big thank you for watching. I will see you guys next week. I'm hoping to have an update on my craft room cleanup at the beginning of the week, hoping for Monday. We'll see how far I get on that. But thank you so much for joining me. I will see you in another video very soon. Okay. All right, let's look at some of these comments. I'm gonna go back. Yeah, I haven't done the microglaze. I'll do that after we're done. There's a debate in the comments on using a comma in the address. You still can, but the post office actually prefers that you don't, have any punctuation in the address at all. So no dots for DR, for drive, no comma after, you know, the city before the state, anything like that. They actually request no commas or punctuation unless it's like a dash that's in the address, something like that. Let me see. All right, I think I saw a question. For a mail call, do we send the card to you in an envelope with a spare envelope included so you can send it out to someone or donate or whatever? Just starting to wonder. You do not have to include a blank envelope. Many people do, and that's kind of nice for the people who I donate the cards to. They don't have to go find an envelope, especially if it's like an odd-sized card or envelope. If you've created a custom envelope for it, that's kind of nice, but you don't have to. There were a lot of people this time that just folded up an envelope and put it inside the card, and then all you have to do is I'll just take it out, unfold the envelope, and put the card inside. That's a really simple way to send another envelope if you'd like it returned. But if you want to include a blank envelope with the card itself, you might have to put your card and blank envelope inside a larger envelope, if that makes sense. Okay. Looking for any other questions. Let's see here. Have I tried the Lindy's Magical Powders? Funny you should ask. I have not, but I have acquired many. And so that's, I'm going to have to, you know, I really want to use them soon. So watch for those. Uh, Carol Schrimmer's asking, mail art? This would be considered mail art. Anything that's not just a regular envelope, I would guess. All right. Well, if there are any other questions, I'll wait just a minute or two to see if any other questions pop up. I didn't see any other ones. Which laser do you recommend? Any of them, really. This was a cheap one that actually came in a tool set years ago. And then one day I was like, oh, wait, that's a laser level. It worked. But just anything, really. Let's see here. I'm scrolling back up. A lot of people were concerned about the shadow on the eye. So glad I caught that. A mint green shadow. Oh, that would have been really cool. Yes, I agree, Scrappy Cat. Let's see here. All right, I've scrolled back quite a bit. I'm gonna come back down to the bottom and see if I have other questions. Question, what about made by on the back of the card for the mail call cards? You can do that, absolutely. Like, no problem. You can do that on the back if you'd like. All right. I think those are all the questions. Thank you so much for joining me today. This is a really, really long live. Some of you have been here the entire time. So thank you. Thank you. I will see you guys next week. Like I mentioned, I just realized the stamp's upside down. That's cute. The stamp's upside down. Whatever. It's flowers. So I will see you guys next week. I'm going to tackle some more of my craft room this weekend. Hopefully you get some of that done. And thank you all for watching. I'll just give a, you know, whew, I've been working hard. My Karen marker box is over there. You see where I threw it when I was getting markers out. Have a lovely weekend, everyone. I will see you on Monday, probably. Have a good weekend. Thanks for watching.